Welcome to Name and Occupation in Depth. We are so excited to bring you today's episode. It is a topic near and dear to our hearts, the Roaring Twenties, aka the Jazz Age.
No subject is terrible if the story is true, if the prose is clean and honest, and if it affirms courage and grace under pressure.
This is a really cool movie, yeah. Midnight in Paris.
It's Paris that kind of started the whole burlesque thing, right?
Yep.
Yep.
Scott and Zelda Fitzgerald, the Fitzgeralds. Isn't she beautiful?
Yes, yes. Yeah, that's a coincidence. It's like a...
You have a glazed look in your eye. Stunned, stupefied, anesthetized, lobotomized.
You know, I keep looking at the man playing piano, and I, believe it or not, recognize his face from some old sheet music.
I know, I could be one of the great writers of musical lyrics, not that I can write melodies, and I try. And then I hear the songs he writes, and I realize I'll never write a great lyric, and my talent really lies in drinking.
Henry Miller wrote The Tropic of Cancer, and it's about his life when he went to live there in the later, mid to later 20s, he went to live there. And it was exactly about that, the poverty levels that existed, but also like the promiscuity that was there on the streets.
Yeah.
That was just, there was such sexual freedom. There was no, that stigma was, it was, whether it was just removed or in the process of being removed, it was very alive at that time. And just the whole premise of waking up and going to the cafes and the bars and, you know, making friends along the way and then doing that same thing all over again the next day.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
It always creates a baby boom after a big war.
Right.
Yes.
Je vais souvent à la rotonde. J'aime bien. Il y a de belles peintures au mur et puis je suis à la bonne avec les filles des cuisines. Mais là-bas, la grande salle, c'est que pour les grandes dames. Alors du coup, moi, je dois rester au bar.
Mais enfin, Kiki, pourquoi que t'essayes pas de t'acheter un chapeau? Comme ça, tu pourrais y aller dans la grande salle.
Eh ben, lui, il doit pas savoir combien ça coûte un chapeau.
French cabaret performer, a painter. She was an artist. And an artist muse. So she inspired men
a burlesque,
to paint, who acquired her nickname for being a fixture in the bohemian circles of the Montparnasse. Art feeds art. So if you're surrounded by like artistic people and you have this like buzz, this energy of artists like Matisse who are painting, Picasso who's painting, Fitzgerald who's writing, just being around these people feeds you. It's like this energy that fuels you.
Yeah.
Imagine, would Hemingway have written The Sun Also Rises without Fitzgerald?
I think Paris was probably one of the most advanced cities at the time, right? Because culturally, it was like the hub, like everybody was gravitating there. And
it revolutionized the world.
Oh, it really did. It was the city of the future. It became like what we are today, right? In a lot of ways.
Yes.
Yeah, that's fun.
I think you nailed it, Andre, when you said that earlier, that the prohibition caused a mass exodus of the states.
Yeah.
Because everybody was like, you know, let's go somewhere else where we can drink.
Yeah, or if you were gay, you'd probably want to go there.
Right.
Because
they were more liberal in their thinking. They were more liberal in their ways. Yeah, we live in the world today where it's generally accepted everywhere, but it wasn't always the case.
Right. And make no mistake, there's places in the world that is still not accepted. Right?
This is
correct.
Yeah.
Which is scary to think.
Very scary.
Hopefully this show will change that. Yeah. Or help in changing it.
We're building bridges here on the
building bridges. Oh yeah, that's cool. And that's the thing, the dancing was revolutionized as well during this period of time because of the exploitation of the music. Because music was just It wasn't so much. It was just that little period where it, where you switched from the ballroom dancing, which was very proper, and then it was more like, okay, let's just kind of just move and go with the flow, and all these like dances were born.
Like in the 20s, that's when they started developing recording systems and stuff like that, LPs, and they would be able to broadcast and, you know, show the music and bring it everywhere.
Well, the culture wasn't just in New Orleans. It's spread.
Right.
Right. We could bring it over there. Right.
Exactly. Look at it. Exactly.
In May 1927, the Paris night quickens with special expectation.
Fashion is just on point.
All those umbrellas.
And look at how proper the men look with the chapeaux.
I want that to come back.
Wait, you're on point with the hat, babe.
Yeah.
Like men were so proper.
The suits.
With their suits and ties.
A magic amalgam of money, leisure.
Oh, the bodysuits?
Look at the bodysuits.
Oh my gosh, you gotta get that.
Let's go.
Wow.
Let's see some bikinis.
Let's bring the bodysuits back.
And the ice box.
And so, because when the men were at war, there was all these vacant jobs, vacant opportunities that needed to be filled, and they were actually filled by women. So then they started making money. And when they started making money, they're like, well, I can buy myself pretty things. I can start going out and go, you know, go to a bar or whatever. It started... It's actually a big period for women. Prior to that, like, your life was finding a good husband that you can marry and, you know, take care of his household for the rest of your life. That was your life. That was like your mission in life, is finding a husband.
Before Picasso became a household name, he was very familiar to the police in Paris. He was a suspected anarchist.
Suspected.
Charismatic old fella, eh?
Contemporary painters, if any, do you admire?
First Dali, after Dali, Picasso, after this, the other.
But these Dali and Picasso are the only two that really...
First me!
...really excite you.
Genius of modern times.
The two geniuses of modern times are Dali and Picasso.
In the moment of paying my soul watches, is the more rigid object for everybody, everybody laughs. The last development of nuclear physics proved that a new conception of space-time is completely flexible.
Now that he said that, you see it in all his paintings. The atomic like influence.
Space and time.
It's true, right?
You remember the one with the elephants with the super, super long legs? And then there's this little dude holding this cross up at them. Yeah, he had some really, really cool paintings for sure.
You know, all artists are a little bit insane in a sense. Exactly. You have to have that.
You have to be.
You have to have that like insanity.
Look at us. Look at this group. We're all geniuses in our own way. We're all a little wacky.
A little
every
wacky.
Single person is
a little wacky.
Who else you gotta be a little crazy to put yourself on the internet like this.
Oh boy.
Yeah, absolutely.
The US stock market exchange crash, right? So all of these Americans who were living in Paris, so then they all started leaving and then going back to America because they had no more money. Okay. So it kind of like stopped everything there because after the 1920s, everything changed after 29.
So the great crash in 1929, the Depression came. Black Friday.
Depression. Yeah, and it was kind of global too, right?
Correct.
Wow, that's epic. Interesting. Yeah, just like that, we're going into the 30s and next thing you know, we're bracing for another war. Crazy. Yeah.